Pesach is around the corner, Chevre. Are you ready?
No.
No? So get ready.
Just now?
Yeah, Pesach is in a few days. We're going to learn a little bit about Pesach from the book of Kedushat Levi Yitzchak, the teachings of Levi Yitzchak from Bardichev. And this can be found in the Drushim, in the teachings of Pesach. And in a week and a half, we're going to be sitting here with a lot of excitement. And we're going to find a question in the Haggadah about a little boy that asks his father, Ma Nishtana? Well, what's the difference between tonight and all the rest of the night? Have a beautiful day. And usually the little kids, they like standing on a chair and they start singing. And all the rest of the guests are like, can you sing a little bit faster? I'm kind of hungry here. And then the rabbi has like 12 kids. I remember the first seder I went to. Not the first, but one of the first ones, maybe 2 years after I became observant. I wasn't really into the seder. I was just into the food. I was starving. And then the rabbi had like 11 kids or something like that. And everyone went in his turn to sing the Ma Nishtana. And I'm like, come on.
Wait, each one sang the whole song?
Yeah, each one sang the whole song.
Each kid gets a verse with that 11
No, kids. They were very frum, very mehader. Every kid stood up. And I'm like, come on, we're going to be eating here at 12 o'clock at night. And every kid stood up and he was singing the song. He wasn't even singing it. He was like asking and questions. And I was like, my gosh, we're going to be here for hours. So, nevertheless, so we want to know, it says, Bepesach shoel haben ma nishtana. In Pesach, the son is asking the father, ma nishtana, what is different this night from all the other nights? Why is the son asking it on Pesach? Why can't he ask it on Purim? Or why can't he ask it on any other night? Why he can't ask on Friday? Abba, why are we dipping the bread in salt? Why are we doing Kiddush? Why we have two chalot on the table? Why can't he ask it on Friday? He had to wait all the way to Pesach, this kid? Why is he not asking in Sukkot? Why are we sitting in a Sukkah? Why are there Zarbatim in him? Why don't we have these questions any other time but on Pesach? Haklal, there is a rule. Ki yesh plukta b'gemara. There is a rule that there is a machloket, an argument in the Gemara. Chad amar b'nisan nivra olam. One Tana said the world was created in Nisan. V'chad amar b'tishrei nivra olam. One Tana says in Tishrei the world was created. This is Rabbi Yeshua and Rabbi Eliezer. V'hine yesh shnei hanagot shehakadosh baruch hu manig et ha'olam. There are two ways how the Kadosh Baruch Hu is controlling and governing the world. Ha'echad, the first one, Shakadosh Baruch Hu manig et olamo betuvo bechasdo gadol. One way Hakadosh Baruch Hu is controlling the world is with great kindness, unbelievable mercy, and amazing goodness and kindness. Tuvo bechasdo. The other way the Kadosh Baruch Hu is controlling and governing the world, vehabet Shakadosh Baruch Hu manig et olamo al yedei tiferet Israel. The second way is that the Kadosh Baruch Hu is governing and controlling the world by the beauty and the glory of the nation of Israel. שהקדוש ברוך הוא מתפאר עצמו עם עמו ישראל. The Kadosh Baruch Hu has, so to say, pride, like a nice, proud father. Look at my son, how he did, scored the best score in the test. He, whatever he did, sometimes you see the father, the mother, they're very proud of the son. Here, the Kadosh Baruch Hu says to all the nations, all the angels, all the heavenly court, he says, look at my nation down there, the nation of Israel. Why? Why is he so proud of? He's proud of the fact that they listen to him and he does what they say. Their will. What is their will? What does he do? That he bestows kindness and blessing on the nation of Israel. When we ask. Basically saying, in other words, Hashem likes when we ask. Hashem says, you ask, I will give you. As long as you're doing my will, as long as everything is good, I will grant your wishes. וזהו הרמז בפסוק אז ישיר משה. We find a hint to that in the verse that we read every day in שירת הים. אז ישיר משה ובני ישראל השירה הזאת להשם. הרמז, what is the hint? זה השירה עצמה אשר אמרו ישראל. This is the actual singing that the nation of Israel sang on the ocean. So it's not like that somebody later on came and wrote a poem. This is what they were singing as they were going out of the water. זה השירה עצמה שר ואמר השם. Why were they singing that? Because they were in a very high level. When they were crossing the water, it says whatever a maidservant saw on the water, the prophet Yechezkel ben Buzi didn't see. They obviously entered into a realm of holiness. They were all elevated to a very high level of Kedusha. And they were able, in some type of a glimpse, of a glance, of a Ruach HaKodesh, to hear what Hashem is singing, so they sang it too. כי הקדוש ברוך הוא, כי כשהקדוש ברוך הוא מנהיג את העולם על ידי תפארת ישראל, when the Kadosh Baruch Hu is running the world, running the show, by glorifying and the beauty of the nation of Israel, אז ממילא רצונם וחפצם, then by default, their will and their desire, וכאשר יאמרו ישראל, כן יאמר השם. That's the will, the desire, whatever the nation of Israel would say, that was also going to be, later on, what the Kadosh Baruch Hu was going to repeat and say. This is the hint in the Talmud. וזהו הרמז בגמרא. חד אמר בניסן נברא העולם. One said that the world was created in Nisan. The Tana, it was Rabbi Yoshua, that says the world was created in the month of Nisan. כי בניסן הוא הנהגה שהקדוש ברוך הוא מנהיג את העולם על ידי תפארת ישראל. In the month of Nisan is when the Kadosh Baruch Hu is controlling the world or governing the world by the beauty and the glory of the nation of Israel. לכך היו להם לישראל ניסים ונפלאות גדולים בחודש הזה. That's why the nation of Israel had huge miracles and merits and נפלאות is like more like wonders, great wonders, specifically in the month of Nisan. Now on the other hand, there's a different Tana. וחד אמר בתשרי נברא העולם. Rabbi Eliezer says, no, the world was created in Tishrei. That's what we know, which is also not exactly precise because the world was created in Elul, not in Tishrei. In the physical world. But nevertheless, זה הוא ההנהגה שהקדוש ברוך הוא מנהיג את העולם בחסדו הגדול. This is when the Kadosh Baruch Hu is controlling and governing the world with kindness and mercy. בכלל, when there is this argument between the two Tanaim, the Arizal says both are right. Because in Tishrei, the physical world, the physical part of the world was created, and in Nisan, the neshama of the world was given. So both are right. Just here, the Levi Yitzchak is explaining it that when the Tana says on Nisan the world was created, he's just referring to the fact that on the month of Nisan the Kadosh Baruch Hu is just governing the world in a different energy. And when the Tana, Rabbi Eliezer, says the world was created on Tishrei, so he explains, no, that's when the Kadosh Baruch Hu is governing the world with chesed, with unbelievable kindness and chesed. That's why we see we have Rosh Hashanah and Sukkot and Yom Kippur. ונמצא, and we see from that, אלו ואלו דברי אלוקים חיים. What do we learn from that? That both are right. Both the Tanaim are right in regards to Tishrei and Nisan, and they're right in two things, when the world was created, and also how Hashem is controlling and governing the world. וזהו הרמז שהבן שואל בפסח. And that's where we can understand why the son is asking specifically on Pesach מה נשתנה, and not any other time. Why? כי באמת זה שהקדוש ברוך הוא מנהיג עולמו על ידי תפארת ישראל, because when we see that the Kadosh Baruch Hu is controlling, governing, and managing, so to say, ruling the world by the glory of the nation of Israel in the month of Nisan, הוא זה שהקדוש ברוך הוא מצמצם את עצמו בעבודת עמו ישראל. Is that the Kadosh Baruch Hu contracts himself and he limits himself in the service of the nation of Israel. What does it mean? Kadosh Baruch Hu puts himself, he contracts himself in all the mitzvot, whether it's tefillin or mezuzah or sefer Torah or talit, that we see that when we serve Hashem, we do mitzvot, we are obligated to put tefillin on. The nations of the world are not obligated, they have their mitzvot. But we have a unique mitzvah that only we are obligated in doing is to put tefillin, to hang a mezuzah, to wear tzitzit, to eat matzah in Pesach and many others. So the fact that we follow what Hashem says, that's the hint that Hashem, so to say, contracts himself, limits himself in the mitzvah that we are performing as the nation of Israel. Now what's the result from that? Yesh lo ta'anu gadol mize. Hashem gets this unbelievable pleasure to be able to contract himself in a physical object, and then we, as the chosen nation to do this mitzvah, we come and do the actual mitzvah, Hashem gives him this unbelievable pleasure. The fact that he gets unbelievable pleasure, ubeze memale ritzonam vechefzam, that he has the desire to fulfill the requests and the whatever the nation of Israel is asking. Veledugma ze hu shelat haben la'av, and this is the hint or the example that we can see that the son is asking the father. What is the son asking the father? Ma nishtana laila ze mikol lelot, what is different tonight from all the rest of the night? Kishekol sicha, sorry, kisechel av gadol misechel ben, the intellect, the brain, the knowledge of the father is much greater than the son. Rak leavat av leaben mitzamtzem atzmo av lashiv tshuva al kushiyat haben. But since the father has this unbelievable love to the son, so the father contracts himself, so to say, in order to answer the question of the son. Because as the father, of course, the father knows why we eat matzah, why we dip the matzah, why we dip the potato or the onion into water or salt and not the matzah, the bread into salt. The father knows that. But the father loves the son so much. If the father would not love the son will say, Abba, what's the difference tonight? The father will tell him, excuse me, son, be quiet. Don't disturb the seder right now. We have to do it and we have to finish it quick. But the father loves the son so much, he says, here, let me tell you why we're doing that. Basically saying, the father loves the son so much, he will contract his intellect to answer to such a simple question. This is the example that we just mentioned. The Kadosh Baruch Hu contracts himself in the attributes of the nation of Israel in order to find glory in them and to do their will. So the same way that here you find a four-year-old, a five-year-old coming to his father, Abba, father, what is the difference in between this night and many other nights? The same way that the father very gladly turns to the son and answers, same thing here. We do the will of Hashem, exactly what he says. I mean, when you're looking at the holiday of Pesach, that's really seeing how we're doing the will of Hashem. You see a whole nation going crazy, not sleeping nights, scrubbing walls, scrubbing floors with toothpicks, taking dirt from between cracks. I mean, this can only be done with unbelievable devotion and love to Hashem. And then usually you see 3-4 days before Pesach, people are not sleeping all night, are up, fixing, cleaning, getting everything ready, and then sitting and doing a Seder Pesach, and we have so many mitzvot on Pesach, specific eight mitzvot that we have to do on Pesach. That's what you see where we are really applying our unbelievable love to Hashem, and we're doing exactly what He says, because really, some things make sense when the Torah tells you to do. Don't steal, I understand, makes sense. Don't kill, makes sense to me. But to start scrubbing my floors with toothpicks and brushing the walls with the toothbrushes and going completely cuckoo, and then that's even nothing. Then go to a house of an observant Jew, the kitchen is covered with boards and foil and everything is covered, and we go crazy here. The tables are covered and wrapped, and then this is done from unbelievable love to Hashem, what a devotion. This doesn't make so much sense in your mind. Sometimes people come to visit my house and like, why are your walls covered with foil? Why is the cabinets of the kitchen are all covered and the tabletops? And the answer is, okay, maybe there's a scare. Maybe there's chametz, or some taste of the chametz is absorbed into the table. And people sometimes look at me like, are you okay? You look completely nuts. There's no chametz here. Chametz, I say, I understand, you remove the bread, but you're talking about the taste of the chametz maybe got absorbed in the table. So you see here the unbelievable devotion that we have to Hashem, and that's arousing unbelievable pleasure in Hashem that to do whatever we want, whatever we ask. That's why we see that the month of Nisan is full of miracles. Miracles and wonders, because we go out of our way to do what Hashem says, so He goes out of His way to do our will. What you want to practically take from that is that Hashem says, listen, I'm not asking much. I'm just asking you to do what I say. When you do what I say, you go completely out of your way, then I'll do what you want me to do, and I'll go out of my way. So we want to learn from that Hashem has unbelievable love to us. that he's willing to stop his agenda and to attend to our needs only because he has this unbelievable love to us. How do we arouse this love to him? How do we arouse this love? By doing what he tells us to do. We have a Torah. We have a lot of mitzvot, Baruch Hashem. All I need to do is follow what the Torah tells me. So needless to say, I don't need to do it in order to arouse the love. I'm doing it because Hashem wants me to do it. But I have to also understand, when I'm doing the will of Hashem, I'm arousing this unbelievable love to us from Hashem. So this is one short explanation why specifically it's the child is asking on Pesach and not any other time. Because according to the argument in the Talmud, on Pesach, the way Hashem is behaving is in a completely different way. And like a proud father that is so proud of his child, that has so much love, and you know, when the father is very proud of the child, then he will do almost anything he wants. This Friday, I'm sure you saw, because my son Yosef was very proud, he came home, he won some award from school, like the student of the month, something like that. And they wrote very nice, he got a certificate, a very special certificate that it says your behavior with Derech Eretz and learning and how you treat your rabbis with respect. And he came home so proud with his thing, the whole Shabbat he was walking with it here. It was going one by one. He was making sure everybody sees it. He was walking with it, you know. So, but needless to say, my wife and me were also very proud, Kol HaKavod. So then he came to me the other day, he told me, can I get whatever Lego set he wanted? I told him, why you want this Lego set? I just came from America and brought you a Lego set. He's like, well, you know, I was the student of the month, and I'm just thinking, maybe you want to reward me for that. I told him, okay, I'll give you a kiss. So, but nevertheless, he's right. When the child does something and the parent is extremely proud, then here, I'll take you out for ice cream, I'll buy you a present, I'll do something. Same thing here, Hashem is proud of us. When we do what we're supposed to do, with all the difficulties that we have, Hashem is proud of us. And he's showing all his angels and all of the creatures and creations of the world, and he says, look at my nation, look, they're look how they're cleaning the floors, look how they're going crazy, how they're spending all their money to buy matzah and wine. And we make Hashem very proud. And specifically on Nisan, is when Hashem says, I'm going to treat this nation based on the fact that I'm so proud of them. Not because I love them or because I'm kind, because I'm proud of them. And that specifically happens on Nisan. Therefore, it manifests into the world that the son is asking the father in the Haggadah on Nisan and not specifically on Tishrei, which is Sukkot. Because Tishrei, it's Hashem is kind. Hashem is kind to us, and Hashem is kind to everybody. Tov Hashem lakol v'rachamav al kol ma'asav. Hashem is kind and good to everybody, animals and creatures and everybody in the world. Do you think Hashem doesn't love the rest of the 7 billion people in the world? But specifically on Nisan, as Hashem has pride in his nation, that's when he governs the world in a completely different way. Like a proud father, therefore the child in Manishtana asks the father, and this is just one short, small hint why specifically in Lel Seder and not in any other time. Bezrat Hashem, we should merit to have our Lel Seder very soon, in the kosher way, in a happy way, in a tahara. Bezrat Hashem, even in a better way, having it after we sacrifice the Korban Pesach. And Bezrat Hashem, should have a kosher and happy Pesach. Amen.